Question when it comes to questions like the goals in Paris is it has to be followed on with changes in our domestic policy, which have to go through Congress. And at the end of the day, Nicole, they result in two very basic things. The price of energy goes up and we have fewer jobs. I'm not for either one of those. I don't think it's stark to fight that. I think it's wonderfully positive. And I think there are a lot of Americans like myself across this country who believe that we can be much smarter in how we approach these things than President Obama was.
Do you believe in climate change?
I believe that the climate fluctuates, absolutely. And sometimes we go through periods of time when it gets warmer, and sometimes we go through periods of time when it gets colder. I do not believe that these carbon caps and taxing carbon and constraining carbon will result in much difference on the temperature gauge. And I think every scientific study shows it. All of these goals, if you actually look at the impact on the temperature, they are so slight. And why are we shedding our jobs for tiny, tiny possible improvements in the temperature?
Matt, well, first of all, tiny improvements.
Please.
If we go 3.6% warmer, the world ends. So tiny
That's
increments.
Not true.
That is true. Every
that
scientist.
Is not true.
Matt, and by the way,
Donna, you sound like a crazy Christian preacher saying the end is near.
No, you sound like a crazy Trump advocate that just drinks whatever he sells. And that's what you sound like, sir.
Well, but Matt isn't.
Well, let's go to the facts.
Let me play, and I want to bring in Peter Baker, who's going to write the story that's going to be on the front page of the New York Times.